من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اما بعد فان اصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار يا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القران الكريم يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون اما بعد My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave us a piece of advice and a warning in one hadith, very short hadith that many of us may know. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Al-rajulu ala dini khalili, falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil." He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "A man is upon the religion or the path or the way of his close companion. So let each of you look whom he takes as a close companion." So in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is advising us to take those whom we want to be on the same path as, those whom we see on a righteous path and we want to follow that path, because we will be on the same path as them. Take them as close companions. And warning you that if you take a close companion, someone who is on the wrong path, someone who follows other than the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, someone who leads you to misguidance, then you will be led to that accordingly. And therefore, we take from this the advice to take righteous companions and the warning from unrighteous companions. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also in another hadith gave us a parable of a righteous companion and a non-righteous companion, a misguided one. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said the example of the righteous companion is that of the musk seller, a perfume seller, the one who sells perfume. And the non-righteous companion is the example of the blacksmith. The reason these two examples were given is because the perfume seller, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said he may either gift you some perfume, Or you may buy from him, or the least, at least, you will leave smelling good, or you'll smell something good when you're with him. So there's always something good. Even if you don't take anything from him, you'll leave smelling good, or having smelt some nice perfume when you're with him. Whereas the blacksmith, when you're with him, then he may burn your clothes, or he may burn you, or at least you will see a rotten smell, or you will leave with a rotten smell. And this is the example of companions. They will have a mark on you. They will leave an effect on you, no matter what. This effect may either be positive or it may be negative. And it's up to you to choose who you stay close to see if this is a positive or a negative effect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Furqan, يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that on the day of judgment, the wrongdoer, he will be biting on his fingers. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. How I wish I took a path of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَا وَيْلَتَا. It's a statement of saying, woe unto me. Woe unto me. لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. How I wish I did not take so-and-so as a close companion. لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي. He has misguided me from the remembrance after I have seen it. Think to yourself, are there people whom you sit close to, who you spend a lot of time with, and you may be saying that about them on the Day of Judgment? Are there people that by you staying with them, you are being diverted away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are there people whom by you staying with them, you are not fulfilling your obligations to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You are being led into sins? If there are, then this could be you on the Day of Judgment. Shouting, woe unto me. woe unto me because of the difficulties that you see that you will have to face on the day of judgment because of the time that you spent with this person. So it's important that we take notice of this. And the very famous story that we know of the person who killed 100 souls before the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wanted to repent. And he went to worship, I asked him, was there any repentance? He said no. He had killed 99 souls by then, so he killed him and he made it 100. And then when he went to the scholar said to him, go to leave this city because there's a lot of corruption and evil in the city, and go to the next city. And he died on the way. And when the angels of mercy and the angels of punishment wanted to see who will take him, it was said to them, measure the distance between the two cities, and he was closer to the city of righteousness. And therefore he was forgiven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had accepted his repentance. But it wasn't, okay, you want to do good, okay, that's it, make sure you do good. No, it was leave these companions, go somewhere else. That was the condition for this person to become righteous, is to leave that city. To leave, because in that city he was known, he had those, his friends in that city. His friends that would bring him back to the misguidance. And he was told to leave it, and only after he left it. And then the angels had measured that he was closer to the righteous city, that is when it was decided, yes, okay, his repentance was true. And this is true for many of us. We say, I want to do good. I want to be the righteous one. I'm going to stop doing these sins. But you are still with the same people that do these sins. You still spend time with these people. You are still attached to them. And therefore, you will not be able to stop these sins. They will drag you back in. They will always drag you back. And the only way for you to stop it, and the only way for you to truly turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to ensure you fulfill the obligations, is to stay away from such people. To stay away from those people. And like this person was told to leave his city to another city, you need to leave such people and stay with those whom remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how a person ensures that he does good. And staying with the righteous brings many benefits, even if you yourself are not righteous. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has angels who their duty is to fly around or go around to see the circles of knowledge and sit in them. The circles of remembrance and sit in them. And these angels will go and they'll find the circle of remembrance and they will sit. And there will be one layer after the other, from the ground, from the earth, all the way up to the heavens, of angels around this circle of knowledge. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to them, where were you? What did you see? They said, we were with your slaves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them, what do they want? They say, your servants ask for Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them, have they seen it? The angels will say, no. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what if they see it? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks them, what do they seek refuge in? What do they want to avoid? The angels say they want to avoid Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, have they seen it? The angels say no. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what if they see it? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what do they seek? The angels say they seek forgiveness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I have forgiven them. And then an angel will say, but Allah, there was this person sitting with these people. He's not from amongst them. He's not a righteous person like them. He just happened to be there. He was only there for a need. So this person, he's not righteous. He was only sitting with these people to fulfill a need. Maybe he wanted to speak to someone, one of them. Or he just happened to sit by. But he himself is not like those righteous people. So the angel is surprised, say, but Allah, this person is from amongst them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُمُ الْجُلَسَاءُ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسٌ. Those are those people, the gatherings, who no one who sits with them will be wretched. Even if he's a sinner, even if he is a disobedient person. But when he stays with these circles of knowledge, when he stays with these righteous people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives him. These are the benefits of staying with those who remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remind you of making you righteous even if you yourself are not initially righteous. We know, we recite on Friday Surah Al-Kahf, and in Surah Al-Kahf Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the story of the boys in the cave. And in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions their dog. A dog is an animal that many people look down upon. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated this dog's status and mentioned it in the Quran. Because this dog stayed with these righteous slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people of the cave, it was with them and it stayed with them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated the status by mentioning it. Whereas on the other hand, you have Abu Talib, the uncle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave so much victory and support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he protected him throughout his whole life. Not many people have given the support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like Abu Talib has, not most of the Sahaba. Yet, on his deathbed, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him to say La ilaha illallah, he was about to, and his companion Abu Jahl said to him, are you going to leave the religion of your forefathers? So he stopped and he didn't say La ilaha illallah. And therefore he died as a disbeliever. With all of his support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will not save him from Jahannam because of the companionship that he took. La ilaha illallah. He was about to, and his companion Abu Jahl said to him, are you going to leave the religion of your forefathers? So he stopped and he didn't say La ilaha illallah. And therefore he died as a disbeliever. With all of his support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will not save him from Jahannam because of the companionship that he took. Because he stayed with those who misguided him and led him away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So staying with yourself will improve and your status will be elevated if you stay with the righteous, and you yourself will be misguided and your status will be lowered if you stay with the disobedient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqeen. The close companions on that day, on the day of judgment, they will be enemies except the pious. All of your close companions in this dunya, they will be your enemies if you both are not pious. They will be enemies on that day. A person sees his friend as a person who supports him, a friend who helps him when he is in need. But on the day of judgment, if you were not both pious, then you will be enemies. So it's for us to see. And these people, the people that you spend time with, judge your friendship with them by the support or by how you feel about them on the day of judgment. Not about how you feel with them in this dunya. We don't say become their enemy, but to take them as a close companion. If you know that you will regret the time that you spent with them in the day of judgment, that is a foolish thing to do. To take someone as a close companion knowing that he will be your enemy on the day of judgment. Rather make your close companions the ones who will be the ones that you are happy with on the day of judgment. When you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you see your scrolls of good deeds and you remember that you did all these good deeds with this person. And this person, he taught you this. Or this person, he encouraged you to do that. So remember this ayah, these words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqeen. That the close companions will be enemies on the day of judgment except those who are pious. And make sure that your companions are those that who will not be enemies to you on the day of judgment. فَقُلُوا قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, for some of you here, this is your first year in a university, and it is a new environment that you are moving into, and you will be making a lot of decisions in these few months that will affect your life forever. And you will be making friends that may stay with you and may become your friends until you die. And that is why it is very, very important that as soon as you start, you choose your friends wisely. You choose those whom you want to be reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you see them, those whom you want to be happy with them on the day of judgment. I personally have seen people who started university not praying, they left and they are praying all their salawat. They started university, only had memorized a small portion of the Qur'an, and they left, they finished at Huffaz, they memorized the whole Qur'an. Whereas on the other hand, there are those who started the university as a normal person, And they left and their lives are all about clubbing and drinking and doing all the haram things. And this all boils down to who a person spent his time with during his time at university. It all boils down to that, and a person needs to ensure that he spends his time with those whom he wants to be their friends until the, and on the Day of Judgment as well. Because the everyone wants you to be, to do as they do. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he said, وَدَّتِ الزَّانِيَةُ لَوْ زَنَى النِّسَاءُ كُلُّهُنْ. The woman adulterer, the lady adulterer, she wishes that all ladies will commit adultery just like she does. And this is common for all sins. A sinner wants everyone around him to do the sin. He doesn't want to be the outcast. He doesn't want to be the only one that's drinking. He doesn't want to be the only one that's doing haram, that's fornicating, that's doing the haram. He doesn't want to feel alone in that. He wants support. And they would want others to sin like them. So if you spend time with those who sin openly, and those who do major sins, and those who do grave sins, then they will lead you to that. Because they will not feel satisfied until you do that sin. Believe me, this person that you spend time with and he drinks, he won't feel satisfied until he sees you drinking alcohol. He won't feel satisfied until he sees you smoking. He won't feel satisfied until he sees you fornicating and committing zina. That is the only time that this person will feel satisfied, because he feels that you are now the same. That you have joined him in what he does. And therefore, it's a person needs to make sure he avoids such people, because that is what they aim to do. It's not that they wish evil for you, but it is that they wish to feel satisfaction for themselves. And the only way they get that satisfaction is when they see others doing the same as them. Whereas a righteous friend, there are many benefits for a righteous friend. A righteous friend is someone who would make dua for you in secret. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, dua for a brother for his brother in secret is accepted. An angel will be at his head saying, for every dua that he makes, the angel will say ameen, and to you the same. You make friends with the righteous, they will make dua for you in secret. Do you think those sinners will be making dua for you? Do you think those disobedient ones who don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly, who don't pray, do you think they will make dua for you? A righteous person, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, al-mu'minu mir'atul mu'min. The believer is a mirror for another believer. So a righteous person will be like your mirror. You go to a mirror to see your faults, he will point out your faults for you. He will point out your faults in terms of acts of worship. He will point out what you are missing, the shortcomings that you have. And he will remind you of them. You didn't pray this salah. He will remind you of your salah. Do you spend time with people who tell you, salah time's up, salah time's coming, we need to pray? Or do you spend time with those who salah is never mentioned in their conversations? Spending time with the righteous elevates your status. As we said, the dog was elevated and mentioned in the Quran because it spent time with the people of the cave. Spending time with the righteous, you learn from them. You see the way that you see the way they pray, you may have a mistake, and you see that they're doing it properly, and you learn from that. Or they remind you, or they teach you. There are so many benefits you can take by staying with the righteous. And although I mentioned it's for those who start university, but it is general for everyone. And a person may think, I've reached an old age, I'm in my 50s or whatever, I'm not making new friends and I already have my friends. That's fine. But there's a difference between a friend and a companion. You can have so many people that are your friends, you know them. You may meet them. But who are those that you spend, you accompany them? Those who you spend time with. Particularly those of us who are, and probably most of us here, who are working, who have families. Your time is so limited. You spend most of your time at work, just with colleagues. Most of the time it's not really close friendship. And then you spend time at home, and the time that you spend outside of these two is very, very limited. So you may have many friends, but make sure that the time that you spend outside family and outside of work, you spend it with righteous companions. You have a lot of friends, choose from those friends, those whom you know are righteous. And spend this extra time or this free time that you have with them. So don't think I've grown up and I've made my friends and it's finished. No. All of us from amongst our friends are a select few who we know are righteous. These are the select few that we need to hold on tight to. These are the select few we need to spend our time with. To make sure that we are reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that we come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through knowing them. Brothers, please come closer and fill in all the gaps. make space, there's still more people coming. And if a person wants to know, how do I identify if this is a righteous companion or not, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith, أَلَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِخِيَارِكُمْ خِيَارُكُمْ إِذَا رُؤُوا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He said, shall I not tell you of the best of you? The best of you are those whom when you see them, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have friends, look from those friends that whenever you see them, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hold on tight to them and spend your time with them. We mentioned right at the beginning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الرجل على دين خليله, a man is on the path or the way of his brother. Imagine this, that you are the person you spend time with, whatever judgment he receives on the day of judgment, you will receive the same. Of course, that's not the reality, but it will be along with those lines. You will receive something similar. So spend the time with those who you see that when they go to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, they will have a good meeting. They will not have a meeting full of anger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or full of listing of sins. Look at your friends and think who of your friends you think is most likely to enter Jannah, and make sure that you stay with this person. So as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you are on the path and on the way of your companion, so you will be on that same path as him. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us all to have righteous companions. Amen. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us all to spend our time with those who remind us of him. Amen. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to have companions whom are not our enemies on the day of judgment. Amen. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to be the righteous companions for others and be those who guide others. وأقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.